And welcome everybody to Terra Restore 2. I am TJ the Obscure here with you. This is a 1.9 map from Mithey, the sequel to Terra Restore, which is a map that I have played and is up on my channel if you would like to check that out. I actually struggled quite a bit with that map, with the bosses, with the mechanics. I had mixed feelings about it, but overall I did enjoy the experience, so I figured I would try this one out. I currently have Kroos's mini CTM 1.9 map on my channel as well. I'm currently trying to really immerse myself in the 1.9 mechanics to get a sense of how they play, how they work, and how I need to adjust my gameplay to fit the new mechanics. So I figured this would be a good map to try out. Once again, this is by Mithey. Mithey, you really need to work on your starting areas, guy. This looks exactly like the one from Terra Restore 1. I would think you would update it, and for such an amazing map, and this really is an amazing map in the sense that it uses a lot of new mechanics, and the command block trickery is quite amazing. It has custom music. There are some really cool things going on the map. One thing that you should know, though, is that the music has to be kind of low because there is custom music in the map, and if you don't have your master volume down, it's very, very loud. Very, very loud indeed. We need to change the options in the map options room to make it much, much more difficult. We need to customize our play experience. Put it on hard. We're going to put it on challenge mode. We are going to keep mob griefing on. And let's go ahead and get started. If you can't tell, I've done the starting area already. I played a little bit on my server. But it wasn't working the best, and I wanted to put it up on my channel, so that's why I decided to go ahead and just start afresh and give you guys the whole experience. Well, not the whole experience. I'm actually going to skip through quite a bit of the beginning stuff here, largely because you've either played the beginning or because you've watched somebody else play the beginning. And it's a lot of cutscenes and story and that kind of stuff. Which I know what you guys enjoy is the action, so I'm going to try my best to skip to that. But I will tell you a little bit about the story. Essentially, you live in this land, the lands of Nera. The races are trying to get together, the villagers, the zombies, the endermen, the creepers. We're all trying to coexist as one people, peace, you know, get together, all that kind of stuff. And it's not going the best. Some of the races, some members of the various races, do not want to get along with others. And so we actually start off our journey with Exile, who is our good friend, an Enderman, which I think was also the bad guy in Terra Restore 1. And we start off our journey in a town with our pal Exile. So I will go ahead and skip to that. Alright, so here we are in the Village of Beginnings with our good pal Exile. Hello, are you gonna turn bad on me or something? Are you gonna, like, betray me somehow? Turn evil? There's a lot of RPG elements to this, which I really enjoy. I mean, the map itself really exists on the boundaries of genre, I would say. It's part adventure map, part CTM map. And, I don't know, not everybody likes that. I'm up for a change of pace, though. The dialogue and stuff doesn't bother me. That there's a story to it, I think, is kind of cool. The music is freaking amazing. If it tries to limit me too much as a player, I will most certainly get frustrated. But for the most part, I think we'll have a good time in the map. Let's go ahead and grab as much as we can. Oh, that's kind of cool. The little piece of cake there. I like that. See, I like all the little small touches. That's nice. Although, Mithey was criticized, I think, for the aesthetics in Terra Restore 1. I really enjoyed them. It was very kind of old-school RPG feel to it, which is nice. It reminds me, it's nostalgia. It reminds me of, oh gosh, we teleport. Sometimes whenever it goes into a cutscene like this, you get teleported, which is kind of frustrating, but you guys are going to have to let me know if the music is too loud. It sounds maybe a little too loud. I don't know. We'll have to give it a try. Maybe I'll pause recording just to give it a listen and see how it sounds. Let's go ahead and grab that bow and arrow. Lovely. So we get kicked out of the town, and it's pretty cool. It's very RPG-like. I recall lots of the games that I played early on in my life starting out in a very similar way. I mean, even Pokemon. Starts out where you're in your hometown, and then for whatever reason you have to leave. Oh, Exile is upset. He is yelling. Because we have to leave. We must depart our hometown. I wonder, do we come back here? Oh, we're in a cannon. We're in a cannon. We're gonna get shot. And this right here reminds me of Secret of Mana. Once again, a very early RPG game. And he's on my head because he can't touch the water. You get it? Ha! Funny. So very funny. Make the jump. Make the jump. Oh, I can't see with your butt in my face, dude. Get your butt and your block out of my face. Yeah, you can just teleport, guy. Why are you on top of my head? Crazy guy. Crazy, crazy guy. Let's grab the mushrooms. All right, I checked the sound. The music doesn't seem too loud, but you guys are going to have to give me some feedback on that, I think. So we're still largely in the kind of tutorial area of the map. So I may edit out some of this stuff. I really want to get straight to the action once again, because I think many of you have already seen the starting area, and it's largely just a tutorial. So let's go ahead, and I think I want that there, and I want to use the axe. I want to use the axe, and he gives us projectile protection, some really strong projectile protection, because skeletons in 1.9 are kind of mean. Kind of mean, to be honest. Oh, I can't reach you. I seem to be struggling to judge the distance to mobs for whatever reason. Let's get over here and take out this spawner, shall we? So these spawners can spawn in sunlight. I got a piece of iron, you guys, already. My skin's kind of messed up right now. Yeah, like the hitbox distance seems different for whatever reason. Let's just do that and that. I know he can still hit me. Whatever, we'll make it. I want your arrow, guy. Thank you very much. What are you doing out here? What are you doing out here, Mr. Skeleton? Oh gosh, you're so quick. You're so quick on your feet, guy. Ooh, let's head over here into this little cave. And we want to light it up. Light it up there, guy. Hop up here or not. Kind of missed that jump there, didn't I? And let's go ahead and grab that. That has even better projectile protection. Projectile protection 10. Wow, okay. Yes. Lovely. So I'm not entirely sure how this essence thing works. I think it may explain that a little later. Not entirely sure. Do I get essence for... No, I don't get essence for breaking these spawners. Something tells me there's going to be goodies up on top of the tree, so I think I'm going to head up there next. Indeed, there is a chest up here with some feather falling. Lovely. Let's go ahead and put that on then. And are these all unbreakable? It's all unbreakable. I'm not sure how I feel about that. Like I said, this one really kind of exists on the boundaries. Can I make it down here? Maybe if I fall on that tree? So it takes out a lot of the survival elements that I really, really like about CTMs. But at the same time, hey, look, it's a potion. Lovely. I don't know, he must have thrown that on the ground for me. Yeah, it takes out a lot of the... Oh, gosh. I hate how it does that. I'm not a fan of that whatsoever. Oh, I missed the jump. I gotta remember, I have freaking a sprint key, guy. You got a sprint key. Use your sprint key. Usually the skeletons like that, whenever they're in large numbers and they're melee skeletons, their sole purpose is to slow you down and to get you to hang out in an area to create further spawns and to just kind of slow you down with mobs and whatnot. I find it's better to just avoid them. I think it's better to just avoid most mobs. Can I get it? Strafe! I got it! What does this say? This says you occasionally run into areas surrounded with a hardened clay ring. These areas contain a challenge that is based around getting to the chest at the end. Okay. Whoa! Well, yeah, do not like the teleporting whatsoever. Let's do the very challenging parkour. I fell! Oh, that's just, yes. I was trying to be, yes. Yes, I did. Oh, gosh. Wow. I'm not even sure what to say right now, you guys. I feel so ashamed. Thank you. Finally, Bob's last sword. This has This has seen many rainy days. This has attack speed boost, so that means that I can avoid the cooldown for the weapons, right? I think that's what that means. Oh, and I love that the music recycles. Very, very nice. Very, very nice indeed. Let's go ahead and hop down. Ooh, I did like a little water jump there. That was kind of cool. And continue on our way. Yeah, we're just gonna run by you. The delay on that spawners is kind of interesting. They, like, just appear in midair. I guess that's how all spawners work, but that they appear, like, sitting down. Low on health and surrounded by monsters, don't forget you can use... Yes, I know. I know! You don't have to tell me. I am the master of the cry box. Alright, I'm out of torches, though. Not good. Can we get a few more, maybe? I already had sticks. And can we just jump over you guys, please? Thank you very much. Light everything up. Well, that guy has a power bow of some kind, or an enchanted bow. I want to take out the skeleton if I can, and then run back in there. Actually, this might be better. Yes, I can just, like, spam click once again, which... I don't know how I feel about that, actually. I was doing this so that I could test out 1.9 mechanics. This seems like it's gonna make things really overpowered, especially because you have that special knockback attack now. Yeah, I feel like the mobs can get closer to me without them attacking me, and I have to get closer to them in order to actually hit them. Alright, let's just hop over here. We got some cobble, we got some apples. And we got an explosion. Cool. Oh, I gotta remember to use my freaking thing. I thought they were gonna attack me. I got really scared for a second, but I think they're just talking. I think they're just NPCs. You guys got any goodies for me? Oh, gosh. Hello. Oh, it's Bob. I have your sword, Bob. I guess we'll go and set my spawn here then. There you go. You got some goodies for me. Thank you very much, guys. And that is nothing. All right. And this says, don't ever switch the difficulty to peaceful. I would never, ever do that. Never, ever do that, I say. All right. Whew. Okay. What are we doing? I guess I should go ahead and make some better equipment, shouldn't I? See, the axe is 9 attack damage, and this is 5 attack damage. But that has the cooldown. Yeah, I think the sword is going to be much better. I don't know how I feel about that. Again, I was really wanting to test out 1.9. Hello there, Mr. Bunny Skelly. Oh, gosh. Are you serious? Wow. Okay. Maybe that's why he put the set spawn thing right there? That bunny rabbit just one-shot killed me, you guys. What the heck, man? Not cool. Not cool, Mr. Bunny Rabbit. Let's shoot you from afar. I thought they took that out of the game, no? Look at him strafe. Look at him dodge. There we go. I got him. All right. Let's get the frick out of here, man. That was just insane. I can't believe I already have a death. That's 2 series in a row now where I've died in the first episode, man. I'm getting rusty. The 1.9 stuff is really... really throwing off my groove. Excuse me. Okay. I just want to hit the thing. Each time you kill a mob, you get some essence. You can also get essences. Okay, you can spend essences at shops. I'm reading this while attacking. It's kind of interesting. Oh, gosh. Okay, I should probably start looking at the mobs now. Enter boss fight. Achievement box. What? I'm doing a boss fight? I should probably destroy these two. Oh, we gotta do a boss fight with Exile. Okay. I'm probably gonna skip through this. Oh. Okay. We have some health potions. Lovely. Maybe I'll attack him with, I'll attack him with fireworks. We'll try that out, yeah? Oh, gosh, no, that's what he's doing to me. Can I just attack him? Why are you betraying me, Exile? I thought we were friends, man. I thought we were friends, dang it. Oh, you're behind me now. Sneaky, sneaky guy. What's with the fireworks? Maybe I should have paid attention. I don't know. This is interesting. I just don't think boss fights are gonna work in Minecraft. This is definitely much smoother than previous boss fights, though. Sneaky, sneaky guy, Mr. Exile. Got him! I killed my friend! I killed my best friend! No! Oh, you're back alive. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna skip this, too. Cool. Told you about this place and how he used to go here. Hey, look, I got a Terra Restore, you guys. Cool. Lovely. Boop. Alright, let's go ahead and take that, and let's continue on our way. Anything up there? No? Anything down here? I imagine there's going to be goodies up there, you guys. Let's check it out. There are goodies, and there are mobs as well. Oop. They're not going to work. Not going to work. They're pretty, but it's not going to work. I still don't have a shield. I wonder why, instead of giving you a shield to help with the skeletons and actually do the 1.9 thing, he decided to give you the crazy, crazy projectile protection. Land of Mir, the monument, your base, destroyed land, Final Fantasy. Yeah, definitely a lot of, oh gosh. Do you truly remember? Oh, there's like little checkpoint stuff, and it tells you how much you've done and whatnot. Interesting. Very, very interesting indeed. Wait, I was somewhere different before. Was that like a teleportation thing? Interesting. The secret veil, what? I'm so confused now. Where am I supposed to go? This way, I think, maybe? Cool the second. Coco the second. Hello, Coco. I think Coco was in Terra Restore 1. Oh, we get a horse. Choose a horse. I think I want... Let's go with the all-black guy, yeah? I have a new companion! Hopefully he's not like, or he's like Shadowmere from Skyrim. I'm trying to remember, there was another horse that I got early on that died, that I killed. I kill all of my followers, all of my companions in Skyrim. It's ridiculous. What did that say? Hero, you have made it. Come find me in the castle in the middle of the land. Alright. So if you played Terra Restore 1, you may know that as you complete dungeons and as you place the Terra Restores, it actually restores, you know, the land around you. Which is pretty dang cool. Summon Horse player upgrades? Really? Huh. I'm gonna take some time to go ahead and figure this out, and I will be right back with you guys. Actually, okay, let's go ahead and talk to him. Skip the scene, please. We've met the goddess of restoration, Vuko. The land was destroyed by a raid of monsters. Some of the villagers got captured, too. Place Terra Restores. Yep. Pretty straightforward. Just adventure south past the gates to a village called Mistwood. I feel like that is a direct reference to something. Where is there a Mistwood in an RPG game? I don't know. We'll have to figure that out. All right. White Wool. Let's go ahead and place that guy. White Wool has been placed. Spectator mode. Very nice. Very nice indeed. Cool. And is that south then? That is indeed south. Alright, so that's the direction that we want to go. A poisonous potato he needs. Little side quests and stuff. That's nice. I'm in spectator mode still, aren't I? No, maybe not. Nope. Alright, you guys, so I checked out my base. There wasn't really much to do there. I don't have enough essence for any kind of upgrades. So let's go ahead and head into the next area. I'm going to try to make as much progress in this first episode as I possibly can. Oh, the lovely... Oh, gosh, the just looks weird. Looks weird. The glitchiness with the teleportation and putting me in spectator mode and stuff like that is... Why am I in adventure mode? I don't want to be in adventure mode. What are you talking about, guy? Summon horse. I'll take the apple. Oh gosh. There you are, guy. Thank you. Delightful info box. This is the overworld. It is here that all the main areas are connected. You will also notice that while in Nera or in towns, that you will be in adventure mode. This means that you can't place blocks or destroy any of the spawners that have a wide spawn radius, and some are only active during night. Okay. So this is interesting. It's much more open world adventure style. Not sure how I feel about that. Nearest fields or Mistwood? I'm supposed to head to Mistwood first, so let's go that direction then. I have a very fast horse though. Is that gonna change anything? Just run by all these guys? I guess I may want to be killing some of them just to get the essences. Don't kill me, Mr. Bunny Rabbits. Don't kill me. I sincerely thought that they had taken the bunny rabbit out. I did not expect it of being one of the killer bunny rabbits whatsoever. Oh, look at the little... Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. I could jump down into the water, you know. Okay. We didn't quite make it. Run! Run, Mr. Horsey! Your front legs got caught on the side. That reminds me of that video of that girl who jumps off of a roof into the pool but just lands a little short. Look at the dancing pigs. Dancing pigs are so cute. Too bad you can't like entice mobs to attack the passive mobs. That might be fun to watch. Watch the skeletons slaughter the cute pigs. Yes, that's lovely. Kind of a random creeper spawner right there. What do we have? 100% safe bridge for horses and other animals. It doesn't say it's 100% safe for me, though. Just for horses and other animals. Hello, Mr. Blue Sheep. Torchfish. That's a Vex reference, isn't it? I think so. Things are far too joyful for my taste. Oh, can I get fish from you? I can't get anything from you. That's cool if he like... I want the wheat! Give me the wheat, dang it! Give me the wheatsies! I guess I wanna press the button. Whoa! Wait, what? Why am I all the way back here? Yeah, some of the cutscenes and stuff are a little confusing for me. What does it say? Are they gonna shoot me? Don't shoot me, guys. I'm a nice person. Please don't shoot me. That's pretty cool. So I'm right there. Where do I want to go exactly? Intersection 1. Wow. All right, so I gotta travel quite a ways to get to the next area, it looks like. But let's go ahead and do that. I really, really want to. Want to get some more action in this episode. I will explore this place later, I suppose. Alright, well, we're here at intersection 1, but there's not a clear indication of where to go. The gentle riverside. Sure, let's go for it. Are you drifting downstream? Maybe. I don't know. Oh gosh, no, I didn't. What am I doing? Close menu. More villagers and stuff, huh? Oh, there's a little baby guy. Shoot the villager! Oh, he's my bodyguard! Ha! Or she, Aria. That sounds like a girl. Come to me, Mr. Skeleton! How are you not dead yet? Guy? Crazy guy? I don't know what they're talking about. Let's move on. Ooh, I can go up this way, it looks like. Alright. Gonna block that off. Oh, gosh. Spam click, I say! Interesting. And some leaves. Some yummy, yummy leaves. I can actually trade my levels for essence, so that's something to keep in mind. Alright, let's get across this bridge, if we can. We're down inside of the bridge. Hello there, guys! Boop, you're dead. Projectile protection pants. I already have projectile protection 10. I don't know if I really need that. That seems a little excessive, to be honest. So far, really easy, really large. To the point where I think it's too big. I've done just so much running around. Spam click for some reason is not as satisfying as it used to be. Are you my friend, or are you just a random enderman? I think you're just a random... Oh, gosh, wait, what? What am I doing? I'm doing a climb challenge, apparently. Oh, I gotta climb the mountain. Alright, I didn't see the... You should probably pick a different color. Green... Green blends in too well with the scenery. I want to come over here and kill this enderman, actually. I can. No! 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 Gosh dang it. Fine, we'll do the challenge. Oh, but I can't... I'm in adventure mode. Huh. I cannot bring it! Jump to the ladder, then! I guess, you know, like, blending... Oh, don't do it to me! Don't do it to me! Blending the genres, I don't think is that bad, actually. This is a nice mixture of survival and adventure mode, I would say. Especially because these seem to be limited to these challenges and to the transitional areas and whatnot. Oh gosh. I need to stop because they're going to keep spawning on my head. At least I'm getting a decent amount of arrows here, it looks like. Alright, we're going. We're running. We're leaving. So many skeletons, you guys. Wow. Alright. Let's try this again, then. Gosh dang it. Or not. Oh, there's a freaking guardian over there. Oh my gosh, you guys. Alright. That turned out to be much, much more challenging than I thought it was going to be. So, I think this may be a good time to go ahead and call the video quits. I've made quite a bit of progress, I would say, and I've gotten myself into a bit of a pickle here. So we will pick up with this next episode. Thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you enjoyed, and I will see you next time.